coach is going through the recruiting process, he or she isn't just looking for an athlete. It's not only about finding skill and what the athlete will bring on the court. The coach is looking for a student athlete. Emphasis on student. A program is built on those who become leaders for the team on and off the court. Those who become leaders on campus and in the community. Once a university coach said to me in an interview, and quote, "My job when recruiting a student athlete is to let their parents know they've done a fantastic job for 17 to 18 years. It's now on me and the university to help them grow even further as a person for the next 4 to 5, end quote. We eventually come to a night like tonight, seniors night, the night to celebrate those student athletes that have become great athletes, but even better students, people, and leaders. And I can't express enough when I say Brock University has a handful to celebrate tonight. Welcome inside the Bob Davis Gymnasium as the Brock women's volleyball team gets set to host the Waterloo Warriors for a 6 p.m. start, followed by an 8 p.m. Brock men's volleyball versus Waterloo Warriors match. I'm Sapir Singh, joined alongside Zach Shabbat, and we welcome you for what is going to be a fantastic night of celebration and volleyball. Not only does Brock celebrate its seniors tonight, something we'll discuss throughout both games, but we might be seeing some of the greatest Badgers of all time play their final game at the Bob. We've got national anthem, starting lineups, and the celebration of the Brock women's volleyball seniors tonight. We'll be right back as we take you to the court level celebrations.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Bob Davis Gymnasium for an exciting evening of Brock volleyball. Today, your Brock Badgers women's volleyball team welcome the Waterloo Warriors. Today's women's volleyball game is proudly presented by the 2019-2020 home court sponsor, Ironwood Wealth Management Group. Fans, at this time, please direct your attention towards the court, where tonight our Brock women's volleyball would like to take a moment to thank three graduating athletes for their commitment and dedication to the Brock women's volleyball program on and off the court. To begin, we would like to take a moment to thank our team manager. Hayden Young has been an exceptional part and Brock women's volleyball program for the last few seasons. On and off the court, Hayden is part of the team. Additionally, this year, Hayden served as game lead manager for the Brock volleyball and was always the first one to arrive and the last one to leave. Thank you, Hayden, for your commitment to Brock volleyball. Morgan Hoffman is a fourth-year psychology student graduating with honors this year. Morgan has been a huge part of building the Badger culture on and off the court. In Morgan's 9 matches as a Badger, she soon got 5 aces, 13 kills, 10 digs, while scoring 18 points and counting. Thank you, Morgan, for your dedication and tonight at the Brock women's volleyball. Darby Taylor is an outside hitter but played all three positions in the front row. Darby is a fifth-year student graduating from the sports management program and pursuing an MBA. Darby has been an academic All-Canadian every year. Rashi racked up 362 kills, 60 aces, 246 digs, 82 blocks, and 472 points in her time. During the 2018-19 season, Darby was named a second-team All-Star with the OUA. Thank you, Darby, for your dedication and commitment. Laura Condotta is a fifth-year sport management student who has started at Brock in 2015. During the 2018-2019 season, Laura was named OUA Player of the Year and second-team All-Canadian. Laura racked up 733 kills, 742 digs, and 841 points and counting in her 84 match career. And starting in April, Thank you.
Welcome back inside the Bob Davis Gymnasium. I'm Sapir Singh with Zach Shabbat, bringing you Brock TV presentation of OUA Women's Volleyball. Getting set is the Brock Women's Volleyball, who's ranked 7th in the nation at 10-3 on the season, versus the Waterloo Warriors, who are 10th in the nation at 9-4. It's going to be an interesting matchup with a lot of playoff implications.
Yeah, obviously, Brock is, like you said, ranked 7th in Canada. They're 3-1 in 2020, currently on a two-game win streak. They're third in the OUA, in kills and 6th in digs, while Waterloo is the hottest team in the OUA, winning 5 in a row, are 4-2 on the road, so they're going to have to improve on that, continue to improve and build off that great start on the road. They're first in the OUA in kills and 12th in the OUA for digs, so they're going to have to figure out this Brock offense and figure out a way to get those passes in for your setter.
Your starters for the Waterloo Warriors tonight are Claire Gagne, Sarah Glenn, Serena Ochadi, Mackenzie Vallée, Jenna Garvina, Karen Fan, and Grace Crooks. For the Brock Badgers, they'll be starting Alana Norris, Christina Jovetich, Sarah Rohr, Morgan Monkman, Aaliyah Torres, Laura Condotta, Grace Pyatt, and Darby Taylor. And the three starters to really highlight tonight for the Badgers are Monkman, Condotta, and Taylor.
Yeah, that's our three seniors for tonight. We're going to have a little stories on them as the game goes on, but right now we're going to focus on the first serve.
And as I did mention, Sarah Rohr is getting the start for the Brock Badgers tonight, with Emily Armstrong having missed the last two games against the McMaster Marauders. So the regular starter and Armstrong out for the Badgers once again for the third consecutive game. And Sarah Rohr, second year setter, who stepped up big last year, stepping up big again tonight.
Yeah, and in her, like you said, in the last two games, they played versus McMaster, and she's averaged 9 assists a game, a set, and 1.85 digs a set. So obviously she's been a key contributor to those wins against McMaster, and hopefully she can help win against Waterloo this year, which Brock hasn't done.
And when I say there's playoff implications in this game, the Western Mustangs lead the OUA West at 10-5. The Badgers are 10-3, and Waterloo is 9-4. Top two teams get a home game, so this game means a lot, not just for playoff seeding, but home court advantage, as we get set with Gagne doing the serving for the Warriors. And this goes right to senior Laura Condotta. She got it off the block there. And a free ball for the Badgers here. Into the middle there. And that off the block is Grace Pyatt, who for the Badgers, it's great to have her back from injury, that she missed a couple games to start the season.
Yeah, she's been having a great season all around, coming back from injury. But going back to Laura Condotta getting that first hit, we talk a lot about first game jitters, but do you think that she has some last home game jitters too?
You know, with celebrations like we just saw, you can get a little bit nervous. Your entire family is in the crowd, but Condotta shows no nerves there.
Yeah, obviously you want to get that first point out of the way on a night like this, your last home game as a Badger, and Condotta gets the second point for the Badgers there.
You mentioned the Waterloo Warriors are off to a 5-game win streak here as they get their first point. So if you're the Badgers, you need to get going early and take the momentum away from this road team.
Yeah, especially that you're 5-2 at home. You don't want to lose that home court advantage in the playoffs if you have the opportunity to get it. So a big win here would help solidify their standing.
That serve came from Mackenzie Vallée of the Warriors, but it's the Badgers who get the point, and they go up 3-1.
Yeah, Christina Jovetich there finds an opening on the right side of the court to get the point.
And Sarah Rohr now serving for the Badgers. She missed 7 games last year for the Brock Badgers. We just get another point, but continuing with Rohr there, in her 11 matches she did play last year, she had 212 assists. In 9 matches this year, she's got 114. And it's great to have a player that can step in with an Emily Armstrong injury. Rohr has experience playing for Team Ontario as well. Badgers in perfect positioning right now. The Warriors will get going here. And off the Badgers block, and that'll stay in, and the Badgers go up 5-1.
And going back to Sarah Roitz, in the OUA, it's very important to have great depth, and that's what Sarah Roitz gives the Badgers. She gives a good depth at the center position, and being as good as she is, she's helping them give some leeway to Emily Armstrong when she's injured or is not having the best game.
Now serving for the Warriors will be Grace Crooks, a second-year player. A lot of second-year players stepping up for this Waterloo team this year, who were coming off an OUA bronze medal a year ago. It was actually the best season the Warriors have ever had, with their 17-2 record and their first ever first place finish in the OUA West Division. Richard Eddy, their head coach, was named not only the U Sports Coach of the Year, but OUA Coach of the Year. And now we are at a 6-4 game for the Brock Badgers.
And that was last year's OUA Rookie of the Year, Sarah Glynn, getting the hit for Waterloo. And we're going to be saying her name a lot tonight, I have a feeling.
A New Brunswick native, that is Sarah Glynn, playing for the Waterloo Warriors here in Ontario. A little bit of a rally here, and we're going to go out to Darby Taylor there, and the senior gets a point for Brock.
And yeah, obviously you want to get all your seniors to get in the game early on, and just it's just another game for them. It's the season's not over. You want to be a contributing factor to this win, and you want to show them some poise.
Christina Jovetich doing the serving there. She's also someone who's got a lot more playing time this year compared to a year ago for Brock. Darby Taylor off the block. A little trick play there. And number 5 for the Waterloo Warriors, Ochadi, puts it down with a tip.
That was a sneaky little play there. She just followed her setter and ended up tipping it on the opposite side of the court for the point.
You can see that the crowd, well, at least we can see the crowd is still filing in for this one. We do have a men's action at 8 p.m. or following this game. Sarah Rohr going to set up here. And there for Grace Pyatt, who picks up another point for the Badgers.
And an important thing to note there is that even though Grace Pyatt got the point there, Ochudi, who's 50 in the OUA for blocks, was blocking Pyatt, and Pyatt finds a way to get the point for the Badgers. So that's a good contributing factor for Grace Pyatt, like we mentioned before. She was out for an injury, and it's good to have her back.
Warriors try to go trick there with their setter, Claire Gagne, but she's not able to get the point off the Badgers. But Brock gets the point as that swing goes into the net. But I want to keep going here on the Waterloo Warriors. When you're talking about their top three kills, players with the top three kills, you're talking Sarah Glynn, second-year player. Mackenzie Vallée, second-year player. Karen Phan, second-year player.
The youth movement is happening with this Waterloo Warriors, is what you're saying.
Exactly. And that helps when you have a fifth-year setter in Claire Gagne. I mean, if we're talking about seniors here at Brock, I'm sure Gagne is going to get a special ceremony over at Waterloo whenever their home game is. We have a 9-5 first set here. Roar here to Morgan Monkman, who's getting the start today. Not a usual starter, but it is seniors night and her final home game, potentially, unless the Badgers earn themselves a playoff game. And miscommunication between the Warriors players there gives the Badgers a 5-point edge.
And going back to Gagne there, the Waterloo setter, she's played 4 years, and she's almost at 2,000 assists in her career, so obviously, like you said, it's very good to have her on that team, especially with a young Waterloo team. And like you said, she's going to get a lot of acknowledgement when she has her final home game in Waterloo.
Mackenzie Vallée, number 6 for the Warriors, puts that down, and the Warriors are trying to chip away at this lead that they've given the Badgers, but still not quite there. And we're talking about 2,000 assists potentially for Gagne. Darby Taylor, she's 5 kills away from a new career high in a season. She had 126 last year, 122 entering this game. And that could have helped her out, but that swing goes wide. talking about other records, Grace Pyatt is 2 kills away for the Badgers for her 200th career kill. Some things to watch here tonight. And Emily Armstrong, who's not playing tonight, was 1 assist away from 1,600 assists for her career as an ace there. And that's the last thing you want to see if you're Steve Delaney of Brock.
Yeah, that's obviously you don't want to see a serve like that be an ace, but Badgers are going to have to regroup and forget about that one.
And a run here from the Waterloo Warriors makes it 8 serving 10. And that serve goes outside, so Gagne gives it right back to the Badgers. And as I was mentioning, the crowd, you can't see it from the camera angles, but the stands on our side of the gym are packed. It's almost getting to standing room level. Great positioning there by Darby Taylor to have some coverage, and Laura Condotta shows emotion after that swing.
Yeah, and that was... Laura Condotta knows where to place that ball, and she's going to hit it, and she hits it off the block there and gets the point for the Badgers.
Grace Pyatt, who will be a senior for the Badgers next year, but we're not there yet, as Laura Condotta, the senior of this year, gets another point, the reigning OUA West MVP.
Yeah, she just hammered that home, and that's a big momentum shift for the Badgers that's going to solidify their lead to 5.
And with that, the Waterloo Warriors are forced to call a timeout, so we're going to take a quick 15-second break. Stick with us here on Brock TV. Welcome back inside the Bob Davis Gymnasium. The Brock women's volleyball team off to a fantastic start, up 13-8 here in the first set. So a quick recap, as the Badgers and Warriors did meet earlier this year, as the Badgers get another point out of the timeout. The Badgers picked up that victory in a 3-2 match. The first set went to the Warriors, first set went to the Badgers 25-18. Second set again to Brock, 25-16. The Warriors came back big time, winning the third set 25-19 and the fourth set 26-24. And that fourth set, a close one, as the Badgers were able to pull out a 4-point victory, and currently are looking for the tiebreaker edge here when you're talking playoff implications and seedings for the playoffs.
And like you were talking to me pregame, you said that the Badgers are the team with the least amount of sets giving up in the year. So obviously a huge 3 sets there against Waterloo. So obviously if you want to get this win, you want to do it quickly. And you know, if you go to 5 sets, there's a chance that anything can happen, right? So if you're the Badgers, you want to end this game early.
Correction. The Badgers lost that game 3-2, not Brock winning that game. That was on my fault. That was back when the Badgers lost 2 straight 5-set matches, 1 to Toronto and then to Waterloo. So the Waterloo holds a tiebreaker in this match. So a victory here would be huge for Brock, specifically under keeping it within 5 sets.
Exactly. And obviously, yeah, obviously that's in the back of your mind when you're the Badgers. And if you're going to win today, you're going to have to do it in 5 sets or less.
But going off that point, you're looking at Brock. Again, you mentioned the least amount of sets lost this year, 13. The next team really in comparison is Toronto, who's lost 16 sets. Then you're looking at Ryerson at 19. But in your own division, the Waterloo Warriors are next on that list with 20 set losses. So Badgers, a 7-set difference there. So not only are they being efficient in their victories and their losses, they're really sending it to multiple 5-game sets.
Yeah, the only game that they really lost without earning a set was the Ryerson 3-0 loss. But other than that, like you said, it was the 3-2 against Toronto and 3-2 against Waterloo. And when you're winning, they're winning in amazing fashion, 3-0, 3-1. You know, this is a kind of team that they know how to win, and they know how to win quick. and efficiently.
Two-game win streak for the Badgers. Four of their last five, but it's the Waterloo Warriors who have won five in a row, and they get the point here, cutting the Badgers' lead to six.
And going up back to that Ryerson game, that we did that game, and the Badgers were in it the whole time. It's just it was an unfortunate Ryerson was just the better team that day, and it takes the 3-0 really doesn't show up on the scoreboard, but they were 100% in it the whole time. And there's a lot of games like that this year that maybe the other team gave 100% and it doesn't show on their scoreboard. So obviously the record might not always show what's on the product on the court, but it's something to keep in mind.
And in an article recapping that loss to Ryerson, Steve Delaney said the Badgers gave away that first set and weren't able to really get back into that match, losing 3-0, as we've already mentioned a couple times. But a better start for the Badgers when we're talking about what happened in that Ryerson game compared to here tonight, being up 17-11. And Laura Condotta will do the serving, and she serves it out. And those are the momentum killers. We talk about it quite a bit. When you have the momentum after a couple points, serving it into the net or wide or out really changes the momentum of the game. Serving now will be Karen Fan for the Waterloo Warriors. And the Badgers get back the point there, and Christina Jovetic will get an opportunity to serve here. Laura Condotta in the right spot there for the Waterloo's kill, but unable to dig that ball out.
And that was Sarah Glynn again. And we're going to be seeing a lot of Sarah Glynn and Laura Condotta tonight. Both of them are top of the league in kills, and it's just going to be a nice battle between the two.
Condotta on her way out of the OUA on seniors night. Glynn, on the other hand, on her way up in the OUA. 2019 OUA and U Sports Rookie of the Year, also named 2019 OUA First Team All-Star and to the All-Rookie Team. So when your first season in the OUA, you're already racking up accolades like that, you've probably got a bright future ahead of you. Badgers trying to regain a point here as Laura Condotta swings it into the net. So the score now reads 19-14 Brock, but going back on Glenn there, she was also named to the Canadian Junior National Team in 2018 and helped the New Brunswick Provincial Team win its first indoor volleyball medal in 2017 at the Canada Games, where the team was able to capture a bronze. So not only is she getting it done here in OUA and U Sports Volleyball, she's getting it done at the national and international level. And the Badgers now 5 points away from taking this opening set up 20-14. Morgan Monkman will get the serve here. Warriors went with three passers. And back set here to Monkman, but she off the block gets her own dig, and Laura Condotta gets an opportunity here. The Badgers in perfect positioning right now. Laura Condotta, who else? But again, the Warriors in the perfect spot. Sarah Rohr back to Condotta, and this time, again, the Waterloo Warriors in the perfect spot. We've got a rally with the Badgers on the offensive attack, and it's Darby Taylor who finds the back line.
That was a great rally between both teams. Both teams are very well positioned defensively, and unfortunately for the Warriors, they just couldn't find a break with the back set to Darby Taylor.
And as the set begins to slip away for the Warriors, they call a timeout. So we're going to take a quick timeout as well. Stick with us on Brock TV. Thank you. It's seniors night here at the Bob Davis Gymnasium. Laura Condotta, Morgan Monkman, and Darby Taylor all playing potentially their last home game as Brock Badgers. Playoffs to be seen. We're going to touch on each player a little bit here tonight, looking at their stats, their careers as volleyball players, not just here at Brock, but prior to and during their off seasons as well. Talk about Condotta playing at the national and international level. And she'll be the one going offhand here. But the Badgers will be called on a double touch there. So the Warriors stay alive here as they trail the Badgers 21-15 in the opening set. Claire Gagne now, fourth year setter for the Warriors serving. Just barely gets it over the net, and that tricked the Badgers as they get called for a double touch.
And going back to that missed serve by Condotta earlier in the set where it gave a lot of momentum to the Warriors, and now it seems like mistakes are making the Warriors come back again. And you don't want to give this team some easy points because they're a team that they know how to win.
And Laura Condotta with a good first pass, and she got up quickly hoping to get the set, but Sarah Rohr surprises the Warriors with a little bit of a set trick. Pyatt now for the Badgers serves. Gagne out tight at the net, so the Badgers will get something to play with here. And again, great positioning by the Warriors. And Kristina Jovetic had an opportunity there, and the Badgers had a chance off the block, but just not able to get it back over the net. So the Warriors, again, only down five. Not completely out of it, although the Badgers are 3 points away from taking the first set.
And the Warriors are one of the teams in the OUA that they're always in the right position from what I've seen so far. And it just goes to show how good this team is.
Laura Condotta off the block, and that will be a Badgers point. And you're talking about the positioning and how good the Warriors are. Again, just looking at the standings, it's completely close. I already mentioned the Western Brock Waterloo group at the top there, but McMaster's 8-7, Guelph 8-6, Windsor 8-7. So there could be a complete flip with 3 to 5 games remaining for each OUA team. So anything's possible right now. Just because you're sitting, you know, in the first seed right now in the OUA West doesn't mean you're going to finish there by the end of the season. Whereas if you look at the OUA East, the Ryerson Rams 13-2, Toronto 12-2, Queens 10-6, and then you're getting to York 8-6, Nipissing 3-12, and the Brock Badgers right there take the opening set 25-17. So good first opening set for the Badgers, but again, like I said, it's seniors night here at the Bob Davis Gymnasium, so it would be only right for us here in the broadcast booth to speak on a couple of the players, or all of the players, I should say, that are graduating for the Brock Badgers, starting with Morgan Monkman.
So yeah, like you said, Morgan Monkman is our first senior that we're going to talk about tonight. She's from a small town of Telkwa, British Columbia, but she didn't stay her whole life there. She went to school in Smithers, which is a town 15 minutes away. Her parents were teachers, and they opened up the school for her and her family to play volleyball in there. So that's where her love for volleyball started. But her mother also played for the UBC Thunderbirds, and obviously that just solidified her love for the sport. Morgan has always loved team sports more than individual sports because it reminds her of the small town feel. Smithers is kind of a tight-knit community, and it's kind of like a volleyball team. Everybody knows each other, and they know you, and it just makes it much more enjoyable when you win together. Prior to joining Brock, Morgan attended Smithers Secondary School, played volleyball there, and then played for the Camelson Chargers. But she has been at Brock for the last 3 years. In her first year, she played in one set for Brock and recorded one kill, but unfortunately, she tore her ACL and was sidelined to an injury for 2 years. Last year as a redshirt, though, she was still a big factor for this Badgers squad as she was a big contributor on the bench and really motivated this Badger squad and never lost hope. This year, in her first full healthy season as a Badger, she played in 15 sets, recorded 13 kills, 5 aces, and 10 digs. and she's been utilized mostly as a serving specialist, but she continues to be a great influence on and off the court. Her Magic career may not have been long, but she continues to demonstrate tenacity and a willingness to never quit, and it's really going to help with the future of the younger players on this Badger squad, and it just shows that dedication to volleyball really goes a long way, and we wish her nothing but the best in her future. So Morgan Monkman, as from us from Brock TV, we thank you for your years at Brock as a Badger, and we wish you nothing but the best.
Thank you for that, Zach. I could not have said it better myself. As the Brock Badgers will take the court in about 25 seconds with the Waterloo Warriors. Badgers taking the opening set, 25-17. You continue to make little spiels like that, I might cry on this broadcast. Getting a little emotional up here in the broadcast booth.
I might have one prepared for you later. You don't know.
Nothing to spotlight about me when it comes to my career. I mean, do we mention the intramural championship that we have under our belt?
We always have to. We always have to bring it back to that.
Once every broadcast, as we get a look from our director to get back to the actual game. A little slow getting started here. Officials starting to look at the numbers on the court, making sure the lineup cards they were handed are correct. Starting serving for the Brock Badgers here will be Morgan Monkman, who we just talked about. So just a coincidence there.
It's almost like it was on purpose, you know?
Monkman with a good first set and a back set there for the Warriors, but they are able to hit the floor three times and keep the ball in the air. But it's Pyatt who goes off the Warriors' block and gets the first point of the second set.
And I gave Waterloo credit for always being in the right position. And there they weren't, but they still ended up getting those digs. And it just shows the tenacity they had to just let their bodies hit the floor and get those balls up in the air to try to get a point for the Warriors.
I was going to credit the Waterloo Warriors coming out of that break. You know, when you lose the first set, you might be a little down, but they had a great first possession, I guess I'll call it. But that second possession wasn't the best, but they regroup and get the third point of this set and now trail the Badgers one serving two. Karen Fenn will do the serving now. Again, I already mentioned she's a second-year player, one of many in the starting lineup for the Warriors. Sarah Rohr to who else but Laura Condotta, who easily picks up the point.
I saw that ball hit that line, and it had a perfect lane, and we had a perfect vantage point of the hit. And like you said, Condotta gets the point.
Condotta does a good job of using the opposing team's block and picking up points, but also getting the opening and getting a massive kill. That's a roll over by Sarah Glenn of the Waterloo Warriors, and that'll go out. So the Warriors are back down only one.
But going back to Laura Condotta, her court vision is impeccable, and she always knows where there's holes and where to place the ball, and it seems like there's always an opening for her. And she always seems to find a way to get to those openings.
Glenn with a serve there, and a back court to Monkman, who just finds the back corner. The Warriors looked like they thought that was going out, but it just finds the corner there for Monkman. Rohr now serving for Brock. That'll be out, so the Badgers go up 5-3 here. 5-2, sorry. And Rohr continues to serve. And the Warriors not able to handle it. So Sarah Rohr on a roll. That
on a roll?
Sarah Rohr on a roll.
That's hard to say.
It didn't roll off the tongue as I thought it would. but that forces the Waterloo Warriors to call a timeout. So go grab a snack. We'll be right back on Brock TV. Welcome back inside the Bob Davis Gymnasium. Quick reminder, the Brock men's volleyball team will host the Waterloo Warriors following this women's match. That one also has playoff implications on the line. Both teams still in it when it comes to the final spot of the playoffs, maybe the third seed. Either way, it'll be a good matchup. But right now, we got to find out what will happen here as the Badgers, again, did lose on the road to the Warriors earlier this season, so they're trying to bounce back at home. Darby Taylor goes for the swing there, and this one goes out to Valet, but it will be the Badgers who get the point. So Sarah Rohr, who continues to serve after that Warriors timeout, had about five or six consecutive serves here, and she'll continue to serve as the Warriors just can't figure out how to make that first pass.
And yeah, they need to regroup and play that defensive style they were playing in the first and always be in the right position, and even their willingness to hit the floor and get the first touch, and they're not doing that right now.
And they try to go with a setter dump there, trick the Badgers, but the Badgers are wide awake right now. Free ball, Laura Condotta, Sarah Rohr, Jovetage, not quite a point, so the Warriors have an opportunity here. Rohr back to Darby Taylor. She had to adjust a little and turn her shoulders, and she gets the point.
But I want to go back to that first that dive by Aaliyah Torres, who keeps the play alive and honestly gives the Badgers some life to get that point, and that's some good credit for the first year libero.
Torres came into this one, 13 matches, 109 digs. Won an Ontario title with the Halton Hurricanes in 2016. She was coached by Steve Delaney, who's the current Brock Badgers head coach. So Delaney and Torres have a history of a player-coach relationship. You see that across the board in the OUA. These head coaches don't just coach at the universities. They have roles amongst the Ontario Volleyball Association or with other club levels, as the Warriors finally pick up a point, stop the Badgers' run. But you have that connection to club volleyball across Ontario, and it makes it a little bit easier to recruit players because you build those relationships.
Yeah, and 100%. And even like players on the opposite teams, you know them because you played against them or you played with them and at the high school level and the club level, and it just helps build those relationships and make these games a lot more interesting because there's stories to tell, you know?
And I only mentioned the Halton Hurricanes because I'm from that region, so I've got to give a shout out to arguably the best region in Ontario.
Did you play for them, Safi?
No, but I got cut before I even entered the gym.
Probably the height.
Thank you, man. Laura Condotta with the serve. And out there to Caitlin Drury. First time we're seeing her in this match. And the Badgers get the point. The Warriors had a chance there, but it's all Brock Badgers in this second set.
And going back to connections that volleyball people make, I actually went to high school with Grace Crooks from the Waterloo Warriors, and she's a year younger than me, but we've crossed paths before, and when we played volleyball, I played volleyball in high school, and we would always watch the women's play, and I could tell that she was going to be a great player, and obviously she's playing in the OUA, and I'm just broadcasting the OUA, so you could tell there's a little difference in the athletes at my school, but it's nonetheless, I just want to give a shout out to All Saints Catholic High School in Kanata, Ontario. We do great things. We have a lot of alumni that play in the OUA. notably Riley Bruce from the Toronto Varsity Blues hockey team. So shout out to Riley Bruce.
There was zero sponsorship to that whole announcement there. I forget what high school you said you went to, but...
All States.
Yeah, there was no sponsorship money coming our way on that one.
Nope.
Complete bias, but Laura Condotta getting set to serve here. And a yellow card to the Waterloo Warriors. I'm not exactly sure what happened there. Claire Gagne was having a conversation with the official, and quickly they get a yellow card. May have been coming out of the timeout too slow. But again, we don't get those messages relayed to us up here, so we can only make assumptions as the Badgers lead 12-3. Gagne outside to Drury, who gets the point for the Waterloo Warriors. Gagne will now serve for the Warriors, so that means they have three swingers at the front, but she serves it right into the net, and the Badgers are back up 13 serving 4. And this isn't complete dominance by the Badgers just yet, or, well, the scoreboard says it is, but a lot of mistakes by the Warriors here in the second set.
Yeah, I mentioned it earlier that they need to play better defensively, and they're not doing that right now, and they're giving the Badgers easy points like that one.
Easy point, as you say. Grace Pyatt just puts it down. Smart, fundamental volleyball there by Pyatt.
And yeah, if the Warriors want to come back in this one, they're going to have to go back to the fundamentals of volleyball and just focus on the pass.
And the Badgers get another point there. Someone we haven't really seen yet in this game is Grace Edwards, who's been solid for the Badgers on the left side. Christina Jovetic now serving. Outside to Fan, who swings it out. The Badgers now up 16-4 at the technical timeout. So we're going to take a break here. You're watching OUA Women's Volleyball on Brock TV. Once again, as we come back to the Bob Davis Gymnasium, we're joined alongside Zach Shabbat. I'm Sapir Singh. The Waterloo Warriors taking their time coming out of that timeout, as the Badgers have been ready quite a bit, just waiting to serve here as Jovetic. So the Warriors really testing the officials' patience here. Jovetic gets the serve finally. Free ball here for Brock. Roar back to Darby Taylor, who has made a couple adjustments this game. That, there she reached back.
That was impressive. She I don't know how her... That was just impressive. The ball was behind her, and she ended up... Even though it was behind her, the ball went straight down, and it was impressive. I guess you learn a few things when you've been playing for a while.
Jovetic again serves here. Gagne to Fan. Jovetic hits the floor. Roar. Condotta just rolls it over here. Gives the Warriors an opportunity. And the Badgers, Shimon Tower block. The Badgers are up 18-4.
And that was Paya and I believe Monkman getting the block there. So that was a great tall connection for the block, and just taking the life out of the Warriors there.
The Warriors here trying to get something going, and they will indeed get a point, but they have a lot to climb back here down 13.
But this Warrior team knows that they've come back against this Brock team before, so I'm sure they're aware that they need to come back, but I don't think they're worried that much right now. They just need to focus on the one point at a time.
And one point at a time is exactly what they'll try to do, but a swing that goes out there by Sarah Glenn gives the Badgers a 19 serving 5 lead. And talking about Emily Armstrong earlier in the pregame talks, she's entered this game, so no injury there. Hasn't played in the last two against McMaster, but now finally in to serve there. And so coming into the game is Gigi Markotic for the Brock Badgers. So substitutions for Brock, for players we haven't seen here tonight, because Brock is handling the Warriors quite well here right now.
Yeah, they have a quite comfortable 15-point lead, but obviously these players they're not just bench players. They've been starters on this team before, and obviously it's just giving the starters from today a little break.
And two players hit the ground as Markotic and Torres. Brock continues to keep the ball in the air, and Karen Fan goes up, and it's the Brock Badgers all day right now for Brock.
I thought you were going with the Matt Bonomi call. I'm going to say all day breakfast.
I did start to miss my basketball broadcast partner there a little bit, so no offense to you.
No, that's okay. Matt Bonomi is great.
Twenty-one-6 now for Brock, but it's the Warriors who get the point there. Grace Crooks will do the serving. Gonna need a huge run here if you're the Waterloo Warriors, but serving it into the net won't help, so Brock is 3 points away from taking a 2-0 lead in a huge, huge game, again, with playoff implications. And the Badgers get another point here, so momentum is all on the right side of the court.
And that was a Morgan Monkman ace. So again, the seniors are stepping up in their final home game. Final regular season home game, I should say.
So Morgan Monkman will try to close out this set. 23-6 for the Badgers. Took the first set 25-17. Warriors just not able to make the first pass, and they show it again, and it's set point, Brock Badgers. Monkman again, this time a better first pass for the Waterloo Warriors, who stay alive there. Ochudi puts that one down.
Yeah, the Stony Creek native just has been quiet, fairly quiet this game, but gets the point there for the Warriors, and hopefully they can start stringing in some points.
Fan now serving. Armstrong's going to have to play it tight there, but it's all Pyatt putting it down. The Brock Badgers dominate the second set, 25-7, lead the Waterloo Warriors 2-0. And again, it is seniors night. I'm not leading you into this player because it's simply easy to put. Greatest of all time.
Yeah, the greatest of all time is a term you could use for Laura Condotta. She's been playing volleyball for the last 12 years, but most notably in the last five, she's played for Brock, Team Ontario, and the National Development Team. But before we get into all that fun stuff, at the high school level, Laura played for one of the top high school Ontario teams in the country. the Bishop Allen Senior Girls Volleyball Team, and in the 2013-2014 season, they had one of the best seasons in the school's history. They participated in several high-caliber tournaments and won them all. The team was the first ever from Toronto to win the prestigious Ontario All-Catholic Tournament, winning all nine of their matches. The team went 45-0 on their way to capture the Toronto District Catholic Athletic Association title for a third year in a row. That year, Laura and her squad attended the OFSA Championship in the quadruple A volleyball division and won back-to-back championships. Laura also played for the club team of the Etobicoke Titans for 7 years, playing a total of 160 games. And in 2013, Laura won gold in the under-15 category at the Provincial Beach Volleyball. And in 2014, she was named a Canadian National All-Star. But at the international level, Laura has earned a silver medal at last year's Women Open and at the 2019 Beach Nationals. So obviously at the international, she's incredible, but it doesn't stop there. Laura has been at Brock for the past 5 years. She's played a total of 289 sets and has racked up 733 kills, 43 assists, 70 aces, 742 digs, and a total of 60 blocks. And in the last 10 years, Laura is actually ranked number one in kills. And the second closest person is 193 kills away. So obviously she's been dominant. Regardless, she's played 5 years and she's still the greatest of all time in that last decade. So obviously her impact has been incredible, and it wouldn't be a surprise to see her in the Olympics someday. And like at the pregame, they said that Laura will be playing for the Team Canada National Beach team. So obviously a great player, and as you said before, greatest of all time at Brock, and we wish her nothing but the best.
And I'm only going off of that with the stats that are available to us. The OUA stats only go as far as like 2010, 2009 or something like that. So I don't know if there was a Brock volleyball player way back when that won like...
In the 80s, yeah.
In the 80s that won like two MVP awards, three... I don't think there's any national titles here at Brock for volleyball.
Not that I can see in the gym.
But we're going to go with Laura Condotta at least over the last few years being the greatest player.
The 2000s. Brock. Let's go with the 2000s.
2000s over the last couple decades. And she came into this one, when you're talking about Laura Condotta and kills, she's on pace for 244 kills on the season. You would think that would be a career high.
It is not.
It's not. Her career high is 245, so she would be one off that pace. But she's had a few kills more so than other games here tonight, so that might change that pace.
And yeah, if she finishes the season strong, like obviously this year hasn't been her best offensively, but she all around, she's been better as a player defensively, and she has a better hitting percentage. So she's having a career year, and she's finally playing for a team that can compete for a national championship if they end up getting there. So obviously it would be the tip of the iceberg for Laura Condotta if they can get there.
And you're talking about a career season for Laura Condotta. She's coming off an OUA West Player of the Year award. So if this is a career year, she's in that conversation for that award once again. Definitely an OUA first team all-star. As the Badgers quickly go up 2-0 in this third set. So they're one set away from taking this victory and having their 11th win on the year. Just complete domination in their victories. We already talked about it. The least amount of sets lost on the year.
And even so, they won that second set in a dominant fashion, 25-7. So obviously they're very efficient when it comes to winning games.
You make errors and you're only giving the Badgers opportunities to put you down. And now Brock is up 3-1 with a fantastic play there by Sarah Rohr. And we have a small timeout here. We're going to have a towel come onto the court to get some wiping going on, avoid any injuries here. The official and Claire Gagne have a quick laugh. Again, we don't have the funding to get mics on these players, so it's not ESPN.
It would be great. It would
it's
be great.
It's not ESPN. Sarah Rohr will continue to serve here. And off the tape, and it leads to a point. Hey, any way you can get them.
Yeah, and I'm sure Karen Fan would want to get that first pass back, but you know, it, when it trickles off the net, you don't know where it's going, so it's unfortunate for the Warriors.
Got to be on your toes nonetheless. Gagne outside here to Glenn. She's been quiet. Well, really, all the Waterloo Warriors have been quiet, but who hasn't been quiet is Laura Condotta.
Yeah, she just shows why she's the greatest of all time with that kill there.
And it's not like tonight where the Badgers have needed a point in any situation, but in games where it is close
she
and momentum
steps up.
Shifting away, she's the player they turn to. But that being said as well, the Badgers being a lot better team this year don't have to completely rely on Condotta.
Exactly, and they're able to spread the offense and share the love for when it comes to kills. And you can see that with like other players like Grace Edwards last year who did take a big step last year and was helping that offense. And this year, it's the entire team stepping up.
And I bet you the Brock Athletic Department is laughing right now with the hire of Steve Delaney. He came in, and laughing in a good way, because Delaney came in last year, first year, and takes the Badgers to a 13-6 record. And again, this year at 10-3, potentially ready to surpass that win total of 13. So he's really turned this program around in just a year and a half.
Yeah, and I look forward to seeing where this program is in the next five. And I'm sure the sky's the limit for Steve Delaney. And he's just a very talented mind in the volleyball world. And again, it's just a year and a half in, but I'm excited to see what the future holds for him.
Won provincial and national medals with the Halton Hurricanes before coming to Brock. Played pro in Finland and France and for the University of Winnipeg. And spent time as a member of Team Canada's beach volleyball team. So Steve Delaney, a huge playing career and now a great coaching career as the Waterloo Warriors call a timeout down 8-2. So stick with us here on Brock TV. Inside the Bob Davis Gymnasium, I'm Sapir Singh, joined alongside Zach Shabbat on Seniors Night here at the Bob Davis Gymnasium. The Brock Badgers taking first set 25-17, second set 25-7, lead the third set 8-2, looking to hold a top one or two seed here in the playoffs with a win as Laura Condotta comes out of that timeout and serves it out. And stick with us, we have already talked about Morgan Monkman and Laura Condotta, two of the three seniors for Brock. We will get to the third senior as well. As much as we talk about the great career Condotta has had, potentially one of the best to ever put on a Brock jersey, another player that actually is a transfer, the last player we'll be talking about. Don't really want to mention her name just yet because I feel like I like to build up the...
You're taking my time away.
Yeah,
you say her name.
Exactly, yeah. Christina Jovetic will serve now. The Badgers are up 9-3. And again, not the best first pass by the Waterloo Warriors, but they'll get an opportunity here with a backcourt swing, but Condotta in the perfect spot. Darby Taylor with a swing off the block, and play stays alive. That was Ballet with a tip, but it's the Waterloo Warriors who do get the point. So still in this third set, only down 5.
And like you said, the Waterloo Warriors seem to be all over the place on the defensive end. And I give them a lot of credit in the first set for their defensive play. And it just seems like they're a completely different team now.
Again, good job by the Warriors taking on some momentum here. Roar back to Taylor and through the block. And Darby Taylor, have yourself a night. Taylor will get an opportunity to serve here. 10-4 Badgers. And a quick set there, or a miscommunication between the Warriors, gives the Badgers an easy point.
And after that miscommunication, fourth-year setter Claire Gagne goes to Claire Grace Crooks to just tell her, look, it's my fault. Let's just regroup and try that again.
And the Warriors do try it again and get the point there. Down 11-5 now.
And the same thing happened on the defensive end. Laura Condotta went to Leah Torres, said, I'll get it next time or just call it and we'll try it again.
Claire Gagne serving now for the Warriors. Roar. And that was Monkman who gets the point for Brock, who now is up 12-5. And just like that, Monkman will get to serve us. So I feel like every time there's a swing, that Brock player rotates into the serving position. Another tight first pass, and that will be a Brock point. So first passes continue to be an issue for the Waterloo Warriors.
And like I mentioned pregame, Waterloo currently ranks 12th in the OEA for digs per set. And obviously that's going to come to bite you back when you want to come back in a game. And defense, in every sport, defense wins championships. And if you can't make your first pass, you can't get a hit. And defense leads to offense in volleyball. And if you can't make the first pass, you can't have that offense.
13-6 Brock with Mackenzie Vallée serving here. Another second-year player for the Waterloo Warriors from Waterdown. Roar to the middle to Pyatt, who swings it out. So 2 points in a row now for the Warriors, who trail the Badgers by 6. Vallée will continue to serve. 3 passers for Brock. Roar to Condotta. We need a point, so why not go to Condotta?
Like we've mentioned in this set, when the Badgers need a point and momentum, they lead on Condotta, and she always seems to answer the bell.
Pyatt will serve now. And Laura Condotta, not the swing she wanted. Almost missed the ball, but still gets the point.
Yeah, she got the point she wanted. That's all that matters for Laura Condotta and the Brock Badgers.
15-7 now for Brock. So, again, another dominating set for the Badgers. Gagne now to Glenn, and the Warriors get a point here. So sticking around, hovering around are the Warriors, but they need to get a lot of points together before they can even think about a fifth or even a fourth set. Grace Crooks now serving. 3 passers for Brock. Monkman, Roar, Jovetic with a tip on the on their toes were the Warriors, and they get another point here, only down 6.
And even in that Waterloo point, there was a miscommunication between Gagne and Achuti, but they get the point nonetheless, and they're starting to come to life.
Back-to-back-to-back points for the Warriors. Monkman, Roar, Condotta, and off the net tape. So 4 consecutive points for the Warriors. They're coming now.
Yeah, they're only 5 points back now, and if you're the Badgers, you just want to get this point and go in the media timeout, and so that Steve Delaney doesn't have to use a timeout to calm them down.
Roar back to Condotta. Again, the Warriors still there. Glenn gets an opportunity, make it 5 consecutive points. And Steve Delaney thinking, and no timeout call.
But Sarah Glenn is starting to heat up, and we mentioned she could be a game changer in her career in the OUA, and she's just showing there how she can take her team to the next level when she's on.
Monkman, Rohr, Jovetic, and that'll be a lift. 6 consecutive points, 12 serving 15. The Waterloo Warriors have awoken.
And the Brock Badgers seem to have no life in them anymore. They just seem like all the life has been sucked out of them, and Waterloo, like you said, have awoken.
Monkman, Rohr, Condotta, and it's the Waterloo Warriors with the strong blocks.
And again, that's if you're Brock, you can't really do anything on that. You just have to get that over, and obviously the block was there, and it was a great block, but you just have to find a way to get those points. You let it come back 7 points in a row now, and if you're Steve Delaney, you're telling them just 1 point at a time. But you don't want them to come back and win this set, because you don't know what can happen in a 4th set.
Steve Delaney, as you mentioned earlier, probably didn't want to call that timeout. The Badgers were a point away from a technical timeout, but 7 consecutive points forced his hand, and he had to have a quick conversation with his team. And you can tell the energy, the posture, and the focus of the Waterloo Warriors has completely changed during this 7-0 run. And a Let's Go Brock Badgers chant breaks out here at the Bob Davis Gymnasium. See if that wakes up Brock. We're getting started here. Continuing to serve is Grace Crooks. 3 passers. Monkman, Norris, Condotta. And that will do it for the Warriors' run. Ends at 7, and we'll have a technical timeout. So Brock finally gets the point they needed. But again, seniors' night. Condotta, one of the best players to ever play the game. Morgan Monkman, fantastic piece off the bench starting tonight. But obviously a great transfer the Badgers picked up a couple years ago.
Yes, and that transfer is Darby Taylor, who is from Thorold, Ontario. So a local talent. At the high school level, Darby went to Eden High School and went to the OFSA Championships in the AA division, and in 2013 and 14 was named the MVP of the game, so obviously was a key factor to her team. Before fully committing to the indoor game, Taylor excelled in the sand, winning the 14U Canadian National Beach Volleyball Championships. Darby Taylor also played for the Halton Hurricanes, like most of her teammates, and helped guide the squad to the 16U Provincial Championships. She also represented Team Ontario in the 2015 Summer Games, and before coming to Brock, like you said, she played in Division I at the Siena College in the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference. That's a tongue twister, and she played there for 1 year and then transferred to Brock. And again, she's been a great addition to this Brock Badgers, and she's actually, in the last 5 years, she's actually 5th on the all-time 2010 to 2010 to now list of kills per set kills. So obviously, it would have been interesting to see what she could have done in a full 5 years. But nonetheless, she's still a great player and a great addition to the Brock Badger squad.
And if you thought 3 seniors was a handful, the Brock men's volleyball team will be playing at 8 p.m. against the Waterloo Warriors, and they have a long list of seniors to celebrate. And we're going to get to that in that game, as the Brock Badgers only up 16-14 here over the last stretch of 9 points. It's been the Waterloo Warriors 8-1. Rohr. We'll get an opportunity here. Back to Monkman, who's having a fantastic final regular season home game with a Brock jersey on.
A
Laura Condotta now getting an opportunity to serve. A little bit of a delay. The Brock men's volleyball team has entered the gym, so they're getting set to potentially warm up. But we're driving right through this game. But if the Waterloo Warriors keep going, we'll have a fourth set.
And Brock knows that this team has come back against them earlier this year. And you know, if you get to the fourth set, the Waterloo Warriors are going to give their all, and that's to finish the game. And if you're Brock, you don't want that. You want to finish it out right now, and because you let it slip. And Morgan Bachman's been having a career game tonight.
And it's important to get a game like this done in three sets if you're Brock, because you're in that situation to get it done. But the reason I say it would be great to get it done in three games is because tomorrow you're on the travel to Guelph, although not a far drive compared to some other universities that you have to go to. You still are on the back-to-back, and it's
still traveling.
Yeah. 19-15 now for Brock, so they're starting to get a couple points here, trying to keep going as Christina Jovetic will get to serve here. A quick conversation for Richard Eddy and his players on the court. Backcourt swing now off the Badgers block. Might have been better off just going no blockers there if you're Brock. Ochudi will now serve for the Waterloo Warriors. Norris, Condotta, and Monkman are your passers. But they don't need to make a single pass as the Brock Badgers are now 5 points away from their 11th win on the season, which would put them 2 wins away from tying their win total of 13 from a year ago. Darby Taylor now continues to serve. Pushed out there to Mackenzie Vallée, and the Warriors get a point, still trailing by three. Claire Gagne, who's been a fantastic server for the Warriors tonight, will get an opportunity once again. Condotta just barely is able to dig that one up, but she shanks it out. So that lead of the Badgers is cut back to two. Darby Taylor and Sarah Rohr will come out. Emily Armstrong and Gigi Markotic will come in. Saw this similar substitution in the second set, but the Badgers had a bigger lead then. Maybe just a momentum changer.
Fresh legs.
Delaney's fresh legs, as you just said. Condotta, Armstrong has to be tight, and an easy point there from Grace Cooks over the smaller Emily Armstrong.
Yeah, Emily Armstrong's 5'6", and Grace Crooks is 6'2", so Grace Crooks has the height advantage at the net.
And we saw this in the first set. Claire Gagne did go on a little serving streak for the Warriors, going on one again. And the Badgers almost picked up a point. Fan, and she gets an easy point as the Badgers' feet are glued to the floor.
And like you said, they're not playing the defensive game that they've been playing the entire game. And now the Waterloo Warriors have come back and tied it up to 20.
20-20. New volleyball match here, and that's not going to help, but the Badgers able to recover. Free ball for the Warriors, and off the Badgers block, the Warriors get another opportunity. Push out there to Vallée, and the Badgers lose the point. And since the first set, it is the Warriors' first lead of this match, and Steve Delaney calls a timeout. But I know, Zach, you wanted to continue on the topic of Darby Taylor.
Yes, thank you, Sapir. I was a little rushed last time. But so since joining Brock, Darby has played 177 sets, not including tonight. And in those sets, she's had 362 kills, 16 assists, 60 aces, 246 digs, and 82 total blocks. And like I mentioned before with Laura Condotta in the last 10 years ranks number one in all-time kills. Darby Taylor actually ranks 7th, so earlier I said 5th. She could end up being 5th by the end of the season. So obviously she's only played 4 years compared to Laura's five. So it would have been nice to see what she could have done in those 5 years and maybe compete for that number one spot.
The Waterloo Warriors run here, led by Claire Gagne, Mackenzie Vallée, and Grace Crooks. Gagne doing the serving here. Warriors up 21-20, make it 22-20, as the Badgers thought that serve was going out, but it leads to a Gagne ace.
And that's not the serve you want if you're the Badgers coming back of a timeout.
Monkman. Armstrong pushes it to Condotta for a backcourt swing, and Badgers again. If you need a point, who do you go to? Lauren Condotta.
And Laura, all the seniors on the court, including Laura, need to bear down and just take the energy out of the Warriors and bring it onto the Badgers.
Laura Condotta doing a good job here tonight, and the Badgers will be able to tie it 22-22. And another substitution here for the Brock Badgers. Monkman will come out. And Samantha Casey, a first-year sport management student, will come onto the court to serve. And she comes in and does exactly what Steve Delaney needed her to do. Steve Delaney looking like a genius.
Yeah, Sam Casey has been utilized a lot for the serve. And just a little more on Sam Casey as Steve Delaney calls a timeout.
That was the Waterloo Warriors.
Oh, sorry. Not Steve Delaney. Steve Delaney looked like a genius. Waterloo called a timeout. I get mixed up sometimes.
Steve Delaney called a timeout to, you know, credit himself. I'm just kidding. That's not actually what happened.
No. So Sam Casey has been playing excellent in her rookie year. I wouldn't be surprised if she's on an all-rookie team. She has 29 kills, 7 aces, 64 blocks, 8 digs. Is a rock defensively and is an all-around great player. So that subs in, gets a point off her serve, and obviously a great influence as a rookie for this Badger squad.
And Let's Go Badgers chants have broken out once again. An almost sold out crowd. Really not a lot of seats left here at the Bob Davis Gymnasium as Samantha Casey continues to serve, and the Badgers bench lets her hear it in a positive manner. Match point now for Brock, 24-22. Casey Armstrong, who else? Lauren Condotta! Have yourself a career! The Brock Badgers take this one, 3-0, and the Badgers pick up their 11th victory on the season. And I don't know if that's just how the volleyball gods wrote it up, but Laura Condotta gets the final point on the regular season here at the Bob Davis.
The story wrote itself. Laura Condotta gets the final point to solidify a 3-0 win over the Waterloo Warriors. And according to the standings, I believe Brock is in first place in the division, so now they need to build off this and continue their hot streak. And unfortunately for the Waterloo Warriors, they lost their first game in 6 games. So they need to bounce back if they want to keep in the momentum they had at the second part of the season.
With this victory, the Brock Badgers move into sole possession of first place with an 11-3 record. Western isn't playing today, so they remain at a 10-5 record. Waterloo falls to 9-5, with teams like McMaster, Guelph, and Windsor sitting at 8 wins on the season. So the Brock Badgers take this match at home, 25-17, 25-7, and 25-22. We do have a Brock men's volleyball match against the Waterloo Warriors coming up, but for the women, the Brock Badgers women's team will be on the road the remaining of the schedule. They're at Guelph tomorrow, February 8th. Then they head to Lakehead for two, February 15th and 16th, and conclude on a weekend of February 21st and 22nd against Western and Windsor. A lot of those games do have implications on the playoffs.
Those last two games are very important.
So the Brock Badgers, as we mentioned, celebrate the careers of Morgan Monkman, Darby Taylor, and Laura Condotta. The Badgers women's team are trending towards a home playoff game, but if for some unforeseeable reason they don't get that home game, for myself and Zach Shabbat, this was potentially our final Brock women's volleyball broadcast. So the people that aren't sticking around for the men's game, we want to say thank you for tuning in over the last 2 years. Never saw myself being a commentator when I came to Brock first. Back, way back when, I don't even know how long it's been. I've been here way too long. Not going to say a complete goodbye just yet. Stick with us as the Brock men's volleyball team gets set to host the Waterloo Warriors here on Brock TV.